So good morning to all. So today we are going to start to solve the one problem of Priestess concrete beam, in which we are going to consider the load balancing concept. And the problem is like this. Following Priestess beam, beam provided with bent tendon the beam carries a point load of 160 kN at center. Determine the stress distribution for the end section and the midsection the beam weighs 6 kN per meter. So this is length of the beam. Total weight dead load of the beam they have given. Okay. And the diagram, which problem you have to solve, the problem is like this. The figure. Beam having length 6 meter here, this distance is 100 mm. Okay, at edges, this distance is 50 mm, and pre-stressing force here 1000 kN. Here also pre-stressing force 1000 kN. Okay, and beam having point load of 160 kN. Okay, so this is the given problem, and we have to calculate the stress distribution at two section, at mid section as well as we have to calculate at the end section. So first we are going to calculate. Here first we are going to write down what is given data. So in this problem, the cross section of beam, they have given 400 by 600. So area of beam, cross section area of beam. The cross section area of beam will be here, 400 by 600 mm. So that value will be 2.4 into 10 raised to 5 mm square. Okay. After that, we have to calculate the section modulus. Section modulus ZD is equal to BD square by 6. So B is 400. 600 square by 6. So section modulus will be 2.4 into 10 raised to 7 mm cube. Okay, so this is section modulus. So we required cross sectional area, section modulus. Okay, in this problem, let the theta here, inclination, this theta we have to consider here while calculating the upwarding forces. Okay, so here we are going to say, well, let theta will be the inclination of the tendon with the horizontal. Let theta be the inclination of the tendon with horizontal. Okay, so here tan theta will be, if you are going to consider this as a, here if you are going to consider this is theta, so tan theta will be front side, okay, divided by adjacent side. So here tan theta we are going to consider as sine theta, because vertical component forces, you know, if you are going to resolve this force, so vertical resistance of forces, you are going to get, this is 2p sine theta, sorry, p sine theta, and this is also p sine theta. So total value 2p sine theta, but sine theta value is very small, that's why we have to consider that as a tan theta also. So tan theta is equal to front side. So if you are going to see the front side, will be here. So this is total, they have your 100, out of which 50 is here, so remaining is a 50. So you can see here, this is 100, okay, and this distance they have given 50, so remaining distance here, so this is 50 mm also. So front side is a 50 mm, so 50 divided by adjacent side of the beam, or that adjacent side is a half of length of beam, so half of length of beam maybe is 3000, so that value is 1 by 60. So this is how you got the value of tan theta. Now analysis, first we are going to see the analysis of end section, what happened with the end section. So first we are going to calculate the stresses, extreme stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber. So extreme stress P by A and minus P E by Z. Why we are considering here negative and positive? What will happen? Due to this eccentricity here, A, the moment going to create like this, okay, like this, and this is going to push this beam upward side. So ultimately when this moment is try to push that beam upward side, obviously tension is at top of the beam and compression at the bottom of the beam. That's why here we have considered tension at the top of beam and compression at the bottom of the beam, these two signs, minus and plus. Okay, so we have to put the value in this formula now only. So values, pre-stressing force 1000 into 10 raised to 3, we have to consider that in Newton. Area already we have calculated, 2.4 into 10 raised to 5 minus plus pre-stressing force 1000 into 10 raised to 3 into eccentricity 50 mm, and then section modulus 2.4 into 10 raised to 7. If you are going to calculate this extreme stresses, okay, the value you can see. Will be the direct stresses plus 4.17 minus plus 2.08. So we are going to get these two values here after solving that, putting the values in the formula, and we have to calculate now stated stress at top fiber and bottom fiber. So stresses at bottom of beam, so those stresses will be plus 4.17 plus 2.08, because bottom is in compression due to that moment due to eccentricity. So net value here6.25 Newton per mm square, and stress at top will be plus 4.17 minus 2.08. So this total value here plus 2.09 Newton per mm square. Okay, so this is how you have calculated the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. You can say this is the sigma B, this is you can say the sigma T. So stresses at top fiber and the bottom fiber of the beam. Okay, so if I am going to draw the sketch for this, the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam, if we are going to consider this is cross section of the beam. (400/600), and if you are going to consider this is neutral axis, the stresses now, if you are going to consider which we have calculated as a direct stresses and the bending stresses, so direct stresses we have calculated by putting value P by A and P by A. So direct stresses are in positive. So those value 4.17 Newton per mm square direct stress and 4.17 Newton per mm square. Okay, and if you are going to consider the bending stresses, so bending stresses due to that eccentricity, negative or tensile tension at top and compression at bottom, and that value we have calculated that P into E by Z, so that value you have got as a 2.09 Newton per mm square and 2.09 Newton per mm square. Okay, so combination of these two, net result will be like this. So stresses at top fiber of the beam positive 2.09 Newton per mm square, addition of these two, And stresses at bottom fiber of the beam will be 6.2525 newton per mm square. And the section stresses are in the section at cross section, at end section and the mid section will be positive. Okay. So this is how you have got the stresses distribution at the end section of the beam. Okay. Now next we have to see the stresses at mid section of the beam. So analysis, of the midsection so while analyzing now the midsection we have to consider the point load okay while earlier we have solved the problem here we have not considered the bending moment due to the point load and self weight of beam because the moment at edges while we are analyzing the end section here the moment due to this point load will be zero and moment due to the self weight of beam also zero that's why we have considered only moment due to the eccentricity okay so now while calculating the moment or stress at mid section of the beam we have to consider this point load as well as we have to consider the self weight of beam as a bending moment okay so analysis of mid section of beam external downward point load at center point load at center they are given 160 km okay but upward resistance or upward point load due to tendon or by the tendon here is 2p sin theta okay why we have considered this upward force due to tendon 2 sin theta you can already have told you that this is the external force 160 kN and the resistance due to this tendon provided bent tendon the component resolution of forces the pre-stressing force is 1000 kN the resistance to this pre-stressing force the two component forces are going to generate and the vertical component is going to resist this pre-stressing force this p sin theta and this p sin theta if you are going to add these two p sin this if you are going to add these two you are going to get the value 2p sin theta so this 2p sin theta is going to resist this force so that's why here we are going to consider the upward point load by tendon is 2p sin theta so after putting the value in this 2p sin theta you can write this 2 pre-stressing force 1000 into theta is 1/60 okay earlier we have calculated the value of theta here you can see by considering this tan theta 50/300 front side divided by length so this is 1/60 that value you are going to put here as a theta so theta is here 1/60 and the value of sin is very less so that's why we are not going to consider that value so here net force we are going to consider now will be 100/3 kN downward okay so net intensity of downward force is this so net downward load so net downward point load will be 160, that is downward load, and minus this 100 by 3. So total here, this force will be 380 by 3 kN, and that force will be the upward force. Okay, now bending moment due to, here we have to consider now bending moment. Now we have to consider the bending moment now. So bending moment due to net downward point load will be plus 380 by 3 into, that is W L by 4, so that will be plus 190 kN meter. Okay, so this is how you got the net bending moment due to downward load. Now we have to add here bending moment due to dead load also. This we have calculated, this bending moment we have calculated for the force only, that 160 kN force. See, I can show you. So here we have calculated the just bending moment for this point load, 160. Now this beam having the self weight, okay, and due to this self weight we have to consider that self weight as a UDL, and for UDL also we have to calculate the bending moment. So next we are going to calculate bending moment due to the UDL or dead load of the beam. So bending moment due to dead load of beam and that will be dead load, they have given the formula here, W L square by 8. They have given the weight, so W into length of beam, so W they have given 6. So 6 into 6 square divided by 8. So this value will be here 27 kN meter. Okay. So we have got the net bending moment due to net downward point load as well as bending moment due to dead load. Okay. So these two bending moments we have considered. Again, we have to consider due to the eccentricity. We have to consider bending moment due to eccentricity also. So bending moment due to eccentricity at the end, so due to that eccentricity the net force here 1000 kN is pre-stressing force into eccentricity 50 into, if I am going to convert into that meter, so that value is minus 50 kN meter. Okay, so net total bending moment, so total bending moment here plus 190 plus 27 and minus 50, so net bending moment here plus 167 kN meter. Okay, so we have considered the bending moment due to point load, bending moment due to UDL, and bending moment due to eccentricity. So three bending moment you have considered for the midsection due to this point load, due to this UDL, okay, and due to this eccentricity also. So these three things we have considered, or these three load condition we have considered for getting the bending moment. And after getting the bending moment, we are calculating the now extreme stresses again. So after getting the bending moment, so extreme stresses, so extreme stresses again, P by A, plus minus m by z. Why plus minus? Because top part will be in a compression, bottom part be in a tension. So that's why we have considered this. So just we have to put the values here now. So P is 1000 into 10 raised to 3. The cross sectional area 2.4 into 10 raised to 3. Sorry, 10 raised to 5. Plus minus total bending moment which you have calculated 167 into 10 raised to 6 if you are going to convert into Newton mm, and then 2.4 into 10 raised to 7 is a section modulus. So after putting the value here, we are going to get the values as plus 4.17 and plus minus 6.96. So if you are going to consider the stresses at top fiber of the beam, sigma t here, so that will be the 4.17 plus, so plus 6.96. so total stress at top fiber of the beam here at the midsection will be 11.13 newton per mm square. So this will be the stress at top fiber of the beam at the midsection. Okay, so next here, stress at bottom fiber of the beam. That is sigma b will be here, plus 4.17 and minus 6.96, because tension is at the bottom, so that net value will be here minus 2.79 newton per mm square at bottom. Okay, so here I can write sigma b, stress at bottom fiber of the beam, will be minus 2.79 newton per mm square. So this is how we have got the stresses for top fiber of the beam and bottom fiber of the beam. If you are going to represent in the form of figure, if this is cross section of the beam, if you are going to consider this is center neutral axis of the beam, direct stresses here same as we have calculated for end section also. P by A direct stresses. Okay, so that value we have calculated as 4.17 newton per mm square. 4.17 newton per mm square. And the value for M by Z we have calculated as 6.96. So this is positive and this is negative, and this is due to this m by z. Okay, and that value we have calculated 6.96. So due to this, the total diagram, now you can see here the top compression fiber will be addition of these two. Okay, and 6.96 minus that 4.17 minus this 6 point, you are going to get the value like this. So here this is 11.13 newton per mm square, and at bottom you have got value 2.79 newton per mm square. These are the bending stresses. and these are the combined stresses. So this is how we are going to solve the problem in load balancing concept when the tendon is plus bent tendon. Okay, so this is how we have solved the problem. They have given data and they have asked us to calculate the stress distribution. They have asked us to calculate the stress distribution at midsection of the beam and the end section of the beam. So we have calculated the stresses. Okay, we have calculated the stresses for, so this we have calculated for the end section and this we have calculated for the midsection. Okay, so next lecture we are going to see the another problem and then we are going to solve the that problem also. So we are going to stop here. Thank you.